going on and welcome back. So if you watch my channel on a regular basis, you know that my car behind me, Project Stepchild, is down for breaking the differential bolts on the rear end. If you're new to the channel, go back and watch. I put a link up here where I broke the differential bolts to the rear end of my car, 2016 Mustang GT S550 with a T56 Magnum XL swap. Anyway, today is the day we get started on putting this thing back together. I do want to show you a few parts that I got in. Got all my stuff from Steeda. So we are on our way to putting everything back together and hopefully getting this car back on the road and then ready for the Whipple supercharger install. So without further ado, let me turn the camera around. Let me show you what I've got to fix the problem and what I've got in addition to that to help the car for drag duty. All right, so first of all, these are the knuckles and the lower control arms for the car. Now, what I got for this is some spherical bearings. So on the lower control arm, that is the spherical bearing there for that. That was a rubber bushing before, which is right there. And on the knuckles, these are the new spherical bearings for them, as you can see there. And there's the other control arm over there. I did want to show that real quick. Had a coworker of mine help me press out the old bushings and install the new bearings. So those are ready to go. And then over here are the other parts from Steeda. A lot of you have asked what my plan was to fix the issue, what parts I was going back with, and this is it here. So what we've got down here are the aluminum inserts for the differential. The factory bushings, which you can see there, they will stay in place. And these inserts will go in there to stiffen things up. There's a hardware there, which we will not be using that hardware. We're going to be using this hardware here. This is the through bolt kit, the 12.9 grade through bolt kit from Steeda. Not cheap, not the cheapest thing out there by any means, but I feel that this will work better than the factory setup, which on the front bushings, it actually takes two bolts, one in the front, one in the rear, but this will replace those and go all the way through. So hopefully that will strengthen things up and we won't break again. And then in addition, here is the differential support bracket, but this should also help to keep anything from breaking and causing this issue again, because we definitely don't want to go through this issue again. All right, so there we go. Those are the parts that I'm going to be installing today. Those are the things that will hopefully fix this problem. So fingers crossed on that. And to give a little update on the axles and drive shaft, I talked to DSS yesterday and the axles were just getting to the inspection process. So it's probably gonna be about another week before I even know what's going on with the axles and the drive shaft. And at that point, I'll be able to make a decision on what to do. So hopefully, you know, fingers crossed on that, minimal damage. And you know, it won't take much to fix them. Get everything fixed, get it sent back so we can get everything back in the car. But like I said, today we're going to work on installing the differential back into the cradle, get that ready to go, and then once the axles and drive shaft come in, we can get everything back in the car, take the car for a drive, and see how everything is going. At that point, hopefully we'll be good to go. But enough talking, it is hot out here. I want to get this done as quickly as possible because it is deathly hot out here. I can't stand it. But anyway, let's get to the install. Let's get this differential back in the cradle and one step closer to getting the car back on the ground. We'll be right back. All right, so real quick, I wanted to stop the installation here. I did run into an issue. Imagine that, running into an issue. Sorry about the fan noise yet again, but it is blazing hot. So basically, with the through bolt kit, you know, the bolt runs on the front side of the differential. The bolt runs through the cradle and threads into the bushing itself. The bushing has a metal insert. It threads into the bushing and then goes through the support bracket and then a nut on the back side. Now, that bolt you're supposed to torque to 129 foot-pounds from the front where it goes through the bushing, or in the bushing, you're supposed to torque it to 129 foot-pounds. Then put the nut on the back side and tighten it up. The problem is, I can't get to the 129 foot-pounds because the bushing, the rubber part, has too much give in it. So there is no way that I can reach the 129 foot-pounds to get that bolt tight and then put a nut on the back side. So let me turn the camera around. Let me show you what I'm talking about. Kind of frustrated at the moment, but let me show you what I'm talking about so you can better understand. All right, so if you can see inside there, that is the bushing inside here. This is the metal insert. You can see there. The bushing is giving that metal insert is wanting to twist, so I can't reach the torque value. Now, if I can't reach the torque value, here's the front side of it. If I can't reach the torque value, then that means the insert is not fully seated against that metal part of the bushing. So that may cause an issue because then it's loose. Technically, it is loose even if I tighten the nut on the back side against the support bracket. So yeah, so the insert itself, not tight at all. You can't get it tight. So that is an issue. So after thinking about this for a bit, I know one of the through bolt upgrades that people are doing is they are actually drilling those out. They're drilling the bushing out, the metal insert, not the steed insert, but the insert that is part of the bushing. They are drilling that out and running a bolt through. So my thinking is I go ahead and drill that out so that the through bolt will go all the way through it, put a nut on the backside, and then I can reach my torque value that way. That's the only option I see that I have in order to get the full 129 foot-pounds against the front of the Steeda aluminum insert. You know, if I don't do it that way, then there's no way that I'm getting the correct torque value, and then I could run into issues yet again. So I'm thinking I'm just gonna drill the threads out, run the bolt through, and hope for the best, you know. That's the only option I see. And the bad thing about these front bolts is they are fully threaded. Now they are 12.9, but I would rather have or not have a fully threaded bolt to get a little bit more strength with the non-threaded portion of a bolt. So it is what it is at this point. I think I'm going to use these Steeda bolts. I'm just gonna drill out the threads in that bushing and be able to run it all the way through and be able to get the correct torque value on it. My thought is, if I can get the correct torque value and everything is held in there tight, especially with the support bracket, I think I'll be good to go. I don't think the differential is going to go anywhere because now you've got that support bracket, and you know that gives a whole lot more support to the front. So I don't really think there is going to be an issue. You know, I am deviating from what Steeda instructions say, but if I can't get the torque rating, then it's going to fail again. So I've got to get that torque rating. Everything has got to be squeezed tight together. And I think with that support bracket, you know, I don't think I have an issue. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to drill it out real quick and get this install finished up with this differential. So stick with me. All right. So got the differential in there finally. I know I skipped a lot of stuff as far as you being able to see the install and what I'm doing. So let me go over everything, you know, kind of piece by piece, bit by bit, so that you can see, you know, what I had to do And I have to explain a couple little hurdles that I had to get over to accomplish this today. So here we go. All right, y'all. So here is the cradle as it sits right now. We've got the differential in there. It is in, and as you can see, the lower control arms are also in. So like I said, I just kind of want to cover everything real quick before we close this out. So here are, let me show you the front bolts. Now, as you can see, I ran them from the back side towards the front, meaning I pushed the bolt through from the back side. Now, the Steda instructions say to go from the front to the back, but as I stated before, and as you can see all over the floor, there's metal shavings. I did drill out the bushings, so now the nut is on this side, and now I am able to get the correct torque value on these inserts, which is 129 foot-pounds. I couldn't get it before because the bushing itself was twisting, so I just could not get that torque value. So anyway, those are torqued down, 129 foot-pounds, and I know now I will be keeping an eye on these bolts to make sure that they remain tight. And I think the way I have it here now, it should be a whole lot easier to get to and tighten up while everything is still in the car. And if I ever have to change out the differential for any reason, it'll be a whole lot easier now that the bolts go this way instead of going through that way, because when this is in the car, the gas tank is like right up against here. So you really can't get to it that well, and you have to drop down the subframe. So anyway, so there's the front bolts for the differential. Here is the Steda support bracket. You've got these two bolts up top that run through the front, and bolt or nuts on the front side there. See that? And those legs go down. So this top bracket, let me show you this real quick. This top bracket, the bolt goes through it. The differential bolt goes through it here, and also these legs here, you know, the bolt goes through them as well. They go underneath. I don't know if I can get you a shot underneath, but let me try. And there's a bolt where it comes from underneath, if you can see that, and goes up through that leg. The leg is threaded, so that shouldn't go anywhere. That should be good to go. And this is gonna help. I think this will really help. I think the way that we've got this now is really gonna keep this differential secure in there. At least on the front side, I don't think it's gonna go anywhere, because you've got this part of the bracket, you've got these legs down here, each side. That's helped holding it up, keeping it in place. Then you got the bolts through, you got the aluminum inserts on the front. I don't think it's going anywhere. So I think we're good as far as that goes. And then of course, on the back, here are the aluminum inserts. Bam, bam. They go through the differential, they actually thread into the differential. I did not drill out the differential to run these just straight through. I did thread it into it, and you know, I can get my torque value on these because the bushing's not gonna turn. The reason it did on the front, because the bushing's threaded. These bushings are just a through hole. So they thread into the differential. So I was able to get my 129 foot-pounds back here, no problem. Then I put the nuts on. Now this side, I do wanna show you this. As you can see, I did have to grind away a little bit of this ear here so that the washer would fit. This side, it could have taken a little bit of grinding, but I was having a hard time getting my my side grinder in there to get that ground down. But I put the washer on there and just tightened it up. Did put a little bit of Loctite on those and torque those down as well to 129 foot-pounds. So I don't think that's going anywhere. I think the differential is about as secure as I can possibly get it. The only other thing I think I could do would be to maybe put larger bolts, drill the ears out of the cover part of the differential and drill these holes out even more. You know, a lot of people are going with like 9/16 grade 8. So I could have done that, but I think this will work. I think we'll be okay with this. 12.9 It's supposed to be, you know, a strong bolt. So anyway, moving on to the control arms. I want to show you guys this real quick, but this is the bearing that we pressed in. Normally from the factory, this comes with a rubber bushing. So from what I understand of what happens when you launch the car, it causes your control arm here can actually move forward. So the tire can actually move forward. And I've seen some slow motion videos on Facebook of that happening. It's pretty wild to see it. So that's what this spherical bearing is for. That should eliminate any possibilities of that. And also, as I said before, these are the new spherical bearings for the knuckles. So kind of the same deal with that. Doesn't allow that knuckle to move around at all. And those are factory. Those are from the factory. These are actually Ford, similar to those. So these come from Ford Racing, but order them from Steeda. So that's not going to go anywhere. The control arm is not going to go anywhere. So hopefully everything will remain solid. Now, this car is probably going to be a noisy bastard. And I am fully aware of that. I am fully aware that that brace is going to probably cause some pretty severe NVH. I'm okay with that. The car is extremely loud. The exhaust is loud as hell. Anyway, so, you know, some NVH. Really, I mean, who cares, you know? Yes, it was nice stock, you know, and it was cool to have kind of a nice ride, you know, but that's not what this car is for anymore. This car is hopefully going to haul some serious butt on the drag strip. I'm not playing around anymore with this car. So NVH, you know, who cares? I know it's going to happen. So if any of you guys out there think, oh, you're going to get a bunch of NVH, I know that. And I don't care. I don't care that that's going to happen. But anyway, so moving on. That's going to do it for today. Man, I am tired. This beat me pretty good. But like I said, that's going to do it for this one. It is excruciatingly hot out here. And I'm whooped, man. I'm whooped. But one step closer. The differential's back in the cradle. I'm pretty excited by that. I mean, that's a big move forward. I can't move any more forward with this car, actually, at the moment, until I get the axles and the drive shaft back. After this video, it may be a little bit before we have any other videos on this car, because I do have to have the axles and the drive shaft, like I just said. So we're at a standstill. So maybe we'll get back on this car, get some wiring done, and you know, make a little progress. But we'll see what happens. Anyway, hope you liked this video. If you did, hit a like button. If you haven't subscribed, please do so, and we'll see you on the next one.